Joaquin Corrales. Welcome back to the channel. Guys, I'm going to keep it short and sweet in this video and get straight to the point here because I was talking to one of my buddies earlier today and he has a Shopify store that's doing pretty good. But the thing is that he's not doing any email marketing. Okay, how do you have a Shopify store? And better yet, how do you have a Shopify store that's doing good, but you're not doing any email marketing whatsoever? And what I was telling him, and I was like, hey, I'm just going to make a video about this because what the hell, is that you need to be doing email marketing if you have a Shopify store, whether you're making money already or not, because it could literally be the difference between your success and your failure. Okay, and the reason why you need to be doing email marketing is because one, you're engaging more with your customers, okay? And just bottom line, engaging more with your customers is gonna be extremely effective because they're going to know about you, they're going to know you, they're going to trust you, and they're going to buy more products from you. So I'm gonna go over three key strategies that you guys need to be following in your Shopify stores when it comes to email marketing to exponentially increase your sales and increase your engagement and increase your brand awareness, okay? Because if people know about your brand, first, next time they see your advertisement, they're going to stop and they're going to look at it because they know about you. You're not a complete stranger brand. And two, they're going to buy more from you, okay? So the first thing that you guys need to do as it relates to email marketing is abandon cart, okay? Abandon cart. And guys, this is extremely important, and this is going to increase a bet. Hold up. This is going to increase your sales by like 20 to 30% if you're able to deploy the simple strategy that I'm about to go over. So this is extremely important. So listen up. So an abandoned cart, what you want to do is that you want to pick the top 4 to 5 products in your store. And you want to set up different abandoned cart series that are really specific to that product. So for example, if someone adds a hat to their product and your store is absolutely killing it with hats, okay, they're doing super good with hats, then you want to add that product to this specific automation, okay? So when someone adds a hat to their cart and then they abandon their cart, you want to, maybe 15 minutes after, begin engaging with them through emails, okay? And what you're going to do is that first you're going to send an email to them and you're going to make it seem like what they did is normal, okay? What you guys have to remember is that as you're engaging with people through email, you have to be super nice, super respectful, and make sure that you, whatever you do, you don't accidentally insult them, okay? I think that this was even something that I was doing initially where I would accidentally insult people. Like, for example, I remember sending an email once to like woman and I said like the word guys and like 10 people were like, what do you mean guys? Like, I'm a girl. And I was like, what? Whatever. So don't accidentally insult people. So for example, what you have to title your first email is, hey, I know that it happens, or hey, I understand that you might have forgotten, or just something of that type that kind of resembles like that it wasn't their fault, that it's normal, that it happens all the time, right? And so you want to send them that email, and what you want to include in that email is a discount code, okay? You want to tell them, hey, I noticed that you left this in your cart, don't worry, I still have it here for you, and you know what, I'm going to throw in a 5%, 10% discount code just so that you could go back in there and make sure that you wrap that up, okay? So you're going to do that, but it doesn't end there, okay? A lot of people who do abandoned cart recovery, they simply stop there, and that's a complete mistake. So you want to go ahead and you want to send that first email with your discount code, and then you want to wait maybe like, so for example, you don't want to wait too short, okay? Some people wait too short, that's not effective. You want to wait one day, okay? And now after you wait one day, what you want to do is you want to check, did they purchase, okay? Did this person purchase after I send them that abandoned cart email? And if they did purchase, then what you want to do is you want to upsell them, okay? You want to upsell them a different product that goes well with that first product that they bought. If they did not purchase, then you need to check if they even opened this email, okay? If they did not purchase, did they open the email? If they did open it, then you send them a customized response. And if they didn't, then maybe you could even send them the same exact email, okay? send them the same exact email. And make sure that in all these emails that you guys are sending, that you're in a couple of them, you're even letting them know that they could respond to that email and let you know for whatever they need, right? People like that personal touch, and people like knowing the fact that they're not talking to a machine, right? They're talking to a human on the other side who is willing to help them when they need it, okay? So this is the abandoned cart strategy that you guys need to put in play when you're using or when you're creating your Shopify. Now, the second thing that I want to go over here are simple upsell sequences, okay? You need to be creating upsell sequences for when people finally buy your products, okay? Let's say that by some miracle of God, someone goes in your store and they actually buy. Like, what the hell? Like, yeah, let's imagine that someone just went in there and they hit the purchase button and they followed through. Can you guys even imagine what that would feel like? So someone actually buys your product, all right? Someone bought it. Awesome, finally. So after they bought your product, this is what everyone does, okay? Boom, flatline. Nothing. They do nada, okay? Nothing. They don't do anything. That's terrible. What you need to do after someone buys your product is first, obviously, send them the email in which you thank them for the order and you give them the information. But then what you want to do one day later is maybe send them a blog post, okay? Send them a blog post about a specific thing that they're related in because they bought certain products, right? Maybe your store is a niche store, like a kitchen store. So you send them a blog post on the top 10 kitchen items of 2018 or whatever, right? And obviously in that blog post, you need to be pointing to different products in your own store, right? So this is like, this is a step further than affiliate marketing, right? A lot of affiliate marketers will send you to a blog that points to other people's products. You're sending them to a blog post for your own products. So imagine you're getting all the money. Awesome. So you're sending them to this blog post. And then what you want to do is you want to continue sending these people emails that engage with them, that get them thinking about your brand, and that shows them that you want to give value to them because you know that they're interested in something in specific. And then what you want to do as well is upsell them, okay? And you want to upsell them by offering different products through your emails, okay? Maybe you offer them discounts, or maybe what you do is that you combine the strategy that we use in our previous abandoned cart email to begin that part of the sequence where you check, are they opening your emails? Okay, maybe I need to repeat them. Now I could offer them this product. Okay, I'm going to offer them this product with a discount code. I'm not sure why the hell I wrote an E here. Whatever. E, okay, you offer them an E. And if they buy, then you do something, then you upsell them again. If they don't buy, then maybe you downsell them. You offer them a product with a different discount code, all right? So this strategy is super effective. And when you combine this with your abandoned cart email, I mean, your Shopify store, like the sales literally double because you're picking up sales that are leaving that you would otherwise not be retargeting, that you would otherwise never be talking to, right? Now, the third thing that I wanna talk about are newsletters, right? And this is kind of like the norm, and some people do this, some people don't, but you guys need to be doing this because all the really big successful stores are doing it, and they're not doing it because they're bored, okay? These stores are not doing this because they're bored, it's because it works, okay? And you guys need to model these stores that are doing things that are working for them so that they could also work for you. Now, the main reason why people do newsletters, why these companies are doing a lot of newsletters, are for one, brand awareness, right? So brand awareness. And two, you're able to sell things, okay? You're able to sell things in these newsletters. But more importantly is brand awareness, okay? And the reason why brand awareness is so important, whether you have a niche store, whether you have a general store, is because people are going to remember your brand and they're going to keep coming back and purchasing you over and over again, okay? What the average person does is that they'll go on Facebook, all right? This is Facebook right here. A freaking box. And what they do is that they'll spend $5, okay, and they'll get $10 back. Okay, let's say you have a successful product going on where you spend $5 and you get $10 back. But then what they're doing is that they're using this $10, they're bringing it back to Facebook to spend $5, get $10 back, spend $5, get $10 back. But that is wrong, okay? You're leaving so much money on the table by not doing email marketing, because what you need to be doing, and let me change the color of this here real quick, what you need to be doing is that, sure, you spend your $5, you get your $10 back, but then what you do with this person's email that you just acquired right here is that you start them on a newsletter, okay? You start them on a newsletter that sends them content every once in a while, combined with offering them different products for them to buy, okay? So then, yeah, sure, you could stay doing this cycle of Facebook, but you're leaving so much money on the table if you're not doing this, okay? And that's the real key here, guys. And so what I've done is that I've created a small program for you guys in Contact Flow. So Contact Flow is my email marketing and sales automation software. It's actually right here. Look at this awesome website we have. It's actually an email marketing and sales automation software. And what you guys are going to be able to do here is you're going to be able to come into this program that I'm going to link somewhere on here, or it's going to be the first link in the bio, to a free program for you guys that's going to show you how to do everything inside of Contact Flow, how to do the abandoned cart recovery, the newsletters, being able to upsell people, being able to check whether they bought something, whether they didn't, right? And being able to respond to that through text messages, through emails. You're gonna be able to build landing pages, okay? You're gonna be able to do cookie tracking through email to see how much money you generated from every single email, all right? You're gonna be able to have your dashboard and have your email dashboard, your financial dashboard. How much money are you making per customer? Because even that is extremely important in itself. Like, for example, if you know that you're making $20 off of every single customer, even though you're selling like $10 items just because people buy multiple of them, if each customer is worth $20 to you, then you know how much you're able to spend on advertisement, okay? And people are doing this blindly, okay? They're not even sure how much money each customer is worth to them, and that is a lot, that is making them lose a ton of money. You're gonna be able to integrate with Shopify, with ClickFunnels, with lead pages, with Facebook, and a bunch more stuff, okay? You're gonna be able to bring your contacts automatically into Contact Flow, okay? They're gonna get segmented with the products that they purchased and everything else, and you're gonna be able to, from Contact Flow, be able to send these people directly to a Facebook audience as well, so that you could create your lookalike audiences and you could start targeting these people. And if you guys have any questions about Contact Flow at all, leave a comment down below. I'm answering to every single comment, and make sure that you guys subscribe, because we have videos coming out on a daily basis, guys. I'll see you inside of the program. I can't wait to see you guys in there. It's absolutely free, okay? It's 100% free. I want you guys to come in here, make a trial. You have a 14-day free trial, and just check it out. It's going to be awesome. So I'll see you guys tomorrow on the next video.